A new report shows demand for freelance work continues to surge, sustaining a trend seen at the onset of the pandemic.
This trend of a general acceptance of employing freelancers or remote workers is now like slowly becoming the norm rather than the exception.
As the gig economy expands, a group pushes for better protection for freelancers.
There are many aspects of our practice and our profession that still need to be studied because there are regulations and policies that are clearly lacking.
I'm April Lee Tan. Join me in the next half hour as we get their insight. A new report from fintech company Payoneer shows demand for freelance work is still growing. Out of the 2,000 respondents, nearly half said they saw an increase in the demand for their work in the past year. This as growing number of businesses rely on freelancers because of flexibility, convenience, and good output. To tell us more about the report, we have Payoneer's country manager for the Philippines, Monique Avila. So to start, can you tell us the highlights of Payoneer's 2023 Freelancer Insights Report? What are your key findings?
Okay, so yes, this is correct. We released the results of the 2023 Freelancer Report in March, and we surveyed 2,000 freelancers across 122 countries, including the Philippines. So the overall sentiment of the report is that it is optimistic. So from the 2,000 freelancers, 46% of them said that they saw an increase in the demand for their services, and 68% of them responded that they believe that this demand will be sustained. And we saw this more pronounced actually with the younger age groups, with the Gen Z and the millennials.
Like, what is the most demanded job among freelancers? Or maybe, you know, what are the top three or top five most in-demand freelancing jobs?
So based on the survey, because this is worldwide, the top ones were related to programming, marketing, and web development. But here in the Philippine context, I can say it's mostly with regards to medical VAs or virtual assistants. And we also see a lot in customer support and also content creation.
And in the Philippines, is it still growing or have we reached a point where it's already static on a year-on-year basis?
With regards to the Philippines, from our own clientele, we can say that it's growing. So with regards to the top market that Filipino freelancers serve, it is mostly the United States. But we're seeing indicators with usage in our platform that Australia is also a growing market. So how did we come up with this conclusion? We have two main products in Payoneer that freelancers use. So we have the request a payment as well as the receiving account. So when you sign up to Payoneer, you will get accounts in USD, in Euro, in Pound, in AED. And for these services, I can say that with regards to the AUD account, we saw an increase of 63% in transactions. And for the request a payment, which is you can send an invoice to your client can respond by paying with their credit card, we saw an increase by 54%. So we see this trend as also, it makes sense because dealing with clients in Australia is favorable with regards to a shorter time zone difference. We're already proficient with the English language, affinity to Western culture. So we saw this trend last year.
So based on your studies, what are the key challenges hounding freelancers both here and abroad?
So with regards to the study, the biggest challenge that the freelancers mentioned is the rising cost of living amidst what is happening in the global economy. So in fact, in order to address this, we saw a lot of responses. 55% of them said that they took on more work to ease the pressure of the rising cost of living. And then 41% also said that they increased their rates. However, there's still a gender pay gap, which we can discuss further. And then also 32% said that they expanded their client portfolio to new countries. So in the Philippines, this is what we see with regards to expanding to the Australian market. With regards to the gender pay gap, so we did see, so there is the gap still, but we saw a marginal improvement. The average rate for women is $22 per hour, and then for men, it's $24 per hour. So, but this is a marginal improvement because in the 2021 survey that we ran, the ratio was 90 cents to a dollar for men versus women. And then for 2022, it moved to 92 cents to a dollar. So there's still the gap. However, what we can take away from this study is that companies that are doing freelancing, they have the opportunity to narrow this gap faster than traditional employment.
Why does that gap exist? Are there certain jobs that people think are more suited for males and are not open to females or something like that? I mean, it's quite surprising that freelance jobs would also have that trend.
Yes, yes. It's very surprising, but I think it's also because most women, according to the study, did not demand for a higher wages more than men. And at the same time, with regards to the industries, women are more participating in the administrative work, whereas men are more in the programming. So, but this is of course evolving. So we hope that in the next year survey, we will see the gap narrowing further.
How or why is this trend of hiring freelancers continuing to grow when, to some extent, there are a lot of employers that have demanded, you know, workers to come back to the office? I mean, why is it still growing? Because understandably, during the pandemic, you know, you would hire more freelancers. But now, you know, people are working more face-to-face back to the office.
Yes. So in our study, we quoted another study by Harvard and BCG. So this study had 700 US-based business leaders, and 30% of them said that they are already hiring freelancers for cost efficiency and also a good extension of their global workforce. And then 90% of these 700 respondents also acknowledge that they will continue to leverage outsourcing platforms to remain competitive. So I think this trend of a general acceptance of employing freelancers or remote workers is now like slowly becoming the norm rather than the exception. So with regards to online platforms, talent platforms as well, it also said in that study that it rose from 2009, there were just about 80 talent platforms, and by 2019, there were already more than 300. In the Philippines context, the most popular platforms for freelancers to find projects or gigs or jobs are Upwork, onlinejobs.ph, and Fiverr. And all of these, Payoneer can connect with.
And on the other hand, don't you think the growing demand for freelancers reflects a bigger problem, such as the lack of quality and stable jobs here in the Philippines? That's why they actually have to go to this route to get a good job.
I think that I would look at it more in an opportunistic angle, because freelancing in the Philippines has become has grown faster, especially during the pandemic. So instead of Filipinos needing to leave their provinces or even the country for opportunities, they can already stay here, enjoy a good quality of life, stay with their families, and then earn in dollars. So I think that we can spin it in a positive way, that it allows our workforce to have to earn dollars while staying in the country.
Yeah, at least you know, the negative impact of you know, working in other countries will not be a problem here, no?
Correct. And also within our clientele, so because we are worldwide, we also manage from here in the Philippines office, overseas Filipino workers that are also doing freelancing on the side. And so they use our services.
Okay, so with that, thank you very much for your insights on freelancing jobs and, you know, the growth in that space. It is also very exciting. Thank you very much.
Thank you, April.
We're taking a short break when we come back.
If you are also looking at the preferences of workers and how society is slowly embracing this non-traditional form this transitional work arrangement, it seems like more people are also choosing to go freelance.
More of our insight when we return. Stay tuned.